Hello everyone and welcome back to Let's Play Okami HD episode 49! Let me tell you, we got a lot of stuff we gotta be doing today. I have already took the time to bloom all the trees here in Seon Village. And to get things started, let's go ahead and sell some of the treasures that we got from the last episode to get a little bit more money in our pocket. And, first let's figure out which one of the buttons we're supposed to actually use, and then we'll sell some of our treasures. Alright. Just go ahead and sell it and just get ourselves some money. Yeah. Alright, that'll do for now. Okay, let's get things underway. To start off, we're gonna head down this alley. Because this alley is where the stray bead actually starts. Talk to this guard here. Their soldier, or whatever. And yeah, man. The water dragon's been gone for, like, at least a year and a half at this point. A little slow in the uptake, I think, but... Well, hey, now that the water dragon is taken care of, we can take care of the thief that is terrorizing the streets of Seiya. You can start this side quest after the water dragon is defeated, obviously, but it's best to do it after you learn Thundershock, which is towards the end of the game, so... To start off... We're gonna light up this lantern here. Because we can't see Hayazo right now because it's too damn dark. So we'll just see if we can't light all these here at once. Yeah, there we go. Alright. Alright, looking good, looking good. Couple more left. Gotta get all the way to that big one over there. There's two more right there. So. There we go, alright. Now we're ready to start the quest. I'll head back to the soldier over here and we'll get things underway. Yes. So now it's time to catch the thief Hayazo. Even though we could have got him without the lanterns, I am confident. We'll, play by the game's rules, wait till night, and now that it's night, he's somewhere around here. Somewhere. He's hiding in one of these, objects, pretty much, and we just gotta kinda slash our way through to make him... Huh? What was that? Ah, there he is. Alright, this is Hayazo. Not very impressive, if you ask me. I wish he could put on some pants. He's a friendly thief, though. Yeah, so this is Hayazo, the Master of Thieves, and I really couldn't find anything relating to Japanese mythology about him, because whenever I type Hayazo into Google, all I get is just this quest. So! Yeah, I really doubt that. It's been so long since we've had talking, I'm not sure what to say. I kinda wanna let it go. Anyway. The idea about the Hayazo questline is that he's gonna split into multiple copies of himself. We have to use a special brush technique in order to take him down. And, it's not that hard at all. So first one, then two. Get him in order. We'll see what he means when he actually does it. So we gotta hit slash on the first on the right, and then hit him with water on the left. And we can do that literally right here. Just slash him right there, and then go over here to the, river, take some water, and then mash him there, and, hey, look at that! Already got him. Yeah, that's some speed you got there. So he drops an item every time that you catch him. This is a pocket watch looking thing. We're gonna take this to Samurai Dandy over here. That's kind of a cool name, by the way. Samurai Dandy. Glass watch, okay. So, return that to him, and we get a nice helping of praise. That was part one. We gotta do this three more times, so we'll come back the next night and see if we can't slash something and there he is. So it's pretty much the same thing, except now he's gonna split into three. Water on the left, and then fire on top, and then slash on the right. Get that in order. So again, we can do that just right here, because take the water right there, and then take the fire, hit him up there, and then we slash him, and that's it! Well, you cannot escape me, motherfucker. You just cannot. Alright, now we got some melee dumplings, or whatever they're called. We pretty much gotta wait until morning, because trying to find this monkey guy, Momotaro, I believe his name, not exactly easy to find. Well, yeah. Bring that to Momotaro, and he'll, be ecstatic and give you some praise. Praise is very important, I have to add. Yeah, Oni Island, Oni Island, Oni Island, I will not play with you, though! So, with that in mind, let's go head back to the alley and go for round three against Hayazo. Alright, now that we're here, we just gotta find his hiding spot, which sometimes repeats where it was before. If I could use the right fucking power, here we go. So round three is about the same as the other two, except, well, now he does it into four. How difficult. Fire, and then water, and then slash, and then back to fire. Not that difficult. Because again, we can do it just right here. Fire on one, then to water on the other, I think. I've already kind of forgotten. Where'd he go? He turned a corner on me! Shit! Ah! If you do lose him, you have until the next day to find him again. So if you run around town enough, do it quickly enough, you'll be able to catch up with him once more. You lose if it's daylight and you still haven't caught him, but I think it also depends if you get the wrong pattern, too. So fire on the last guy, and there we go, finally. Sheesh. So now we got this weird-looking whatever it is. I forget what it's called. We need to take this to the restaurant here in the commoner's part. Take this, then make a right. Yes, this is Yama's restaurant. I forget who exactly I take this to, so I guess we'll start by heading back here. This frustrated fellow. Top chef, huh? You look like a cat. So, I really don't even remember where we got it, but we gotten the gold mushroom long time ago. Like a real long time ago. I don't even remember getting it. So what's gonna be happening when we finish some of these cutscenes, or not these cutscenes, these side quests, he's gonna be looking for an item that we somehow have, and I forgot how we actually got. So with this golden mushroom, it has nothing to do with the Hayazo quest, unbeknownst to my knowledge. You give him the golden mushroom, and then he's gonna give you something real special, relating to the ultimate dish. Talk to him again and to get it started. So, alright, Fiery Chef Yama, give us the ultimate dish. I think we've built it up a little bit too much. Whoa! And then you, just make an infinity symbol. And now you have free fire whenever you want it! Apparently, by giving that man the mushroom and making the ultimate dish, we have powered up. That is, powered up our Inferno technique. We don't have to use a pool to use fire anymore. We can just make an infinity symbol and using, like, about, I think, three ink pots. Yeesh. You get fire on command. Lovely. And we get a bunch of food, too. It's great. I just need to finish this talking part before it goes away. It's gonna vanish. 50 praise, though. That is not a small number. So, yeah, cool. We got ourselves another Inferno tech. That's interesting. Works out quite well. And with that, we get a chest that has a technique scroll of the Inferno tech. So it was very important that we actually did this. It just didn't matter when we did it, just glad that we did it, so we don't have to do it on another later episode. So then, we offer the Chrysanthemum Hairpin, the thing we got from Hayazo, over to this guy. And he gives us 20 more praise. That's already like 60 praise we got just from Hayazo. And the 50 we got from Yama, that's a hell of a lot. We're getting a lot of praise. Alright, now it's time for the final round with Hayazo. And it's best to do this, like I said, probably after you get Thunder Shock, which is after Lechku and Nechku towards the end of the game, so... because now he's going to do something a little bit tricky that hasn't done before. He splits into five, you get Water, and Fire, and then Slash, and then Electricity, and Slash again. So now I got to remember what all five... I can remember what the actual pattern was, which I don't think I remember now at the time of speaking right now. But there is a trick with the lightning there. You could use the lightning blade that you got from beating Lechku and Nechku, but there's also a ghost somewhere around here that has an electricity power. But we'll go ahead and equip our Thunder Edge because we're cool and awesome, and we have it. We'll just follow him around for a bit until I get close enough. Where's he going? Well, I'll go ahead and shock him right now, then. I'm pretty sure we'll run past that ghost. Did I miss? I fucking missed. What the hell? There. That. If yellow stuff's coming out of my brush, do you really think that I want to fucking use flowery blooms? Whatever. At least you got him. So it feels like his magic gives us another 50 praise! Holy shit! Where are we getting all this praise from, man? So now Hayagazo's gone, and we got a mask. Looks lovely. Huh. So, where do we take this thing? Well, I'll tell you. Basically, we're gonna take it back to the alleyway, and we're gonna head back up to the Tau Palace, where we ended things last episode. All the way up here, yes sir, yes sir. Alright. Let's head inside here. We need to talk back, huh? So this is Abe. He is the one who's missing this Tau mask. So we'll just give it back to him. And another 50 praise! Jesus! We're gonna be like super powerful demigods by the- well, we already are gods, but even more powerful by the time we actually start to finish the game. And as a result, we get Stray Bead 49. Wow. So, a secret about Captain Waka. If he would have brought back this time, I see he was going to tell us a secret. But the thing is, Waka, apparently... I'll just let Abe explain. Over 200 years, it's only been Waka. That is weird. That's even more than 100 years ago when Orochi started that tradition of Kamiki Village. The Waka's really old then. Huh. Well, that's all we need to do here. Let's head to our next area! Which isn't that far away. Really, we need to go into the aristocratic area for a little bit. Need to do a couple things here. A couple of also very important things. It can be day or night, doesn't matter. But if you have followed Komoso from Kamiki Village and Kusa Village and did it fast enough, he should be now here in Seon. But because we're so unbelievably powerful, it should be easy to do. We can beat these enemies in 30 seconds or less. And by that I mean use an exorcism slip to make it a lot easier and destroy them immediately. Ha 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 ha. Not only do we get an extra little bit of money, Komoso is going to be absolutely flabbergasted by that. So this being the third time, that was the last Komoso challenge. And so he gives us stray bead, 52, and 20 praise. God, again with the praise. We are unstoppable right now. We are unstoppable. Not done yet, though. One thing to do in the castle real quick. The usual fail of Mr. Pass by these guys, because even though we've saved Himiko, and Himiko's not even alive anymore, they still need to hold guard like that. Very weird. So, make our way up here. Need to head behind the actual palace. And here we are. This is the grave of Queen Himiko. And again, even though it's been like a year and a half, 2 years since she died, well, what better time than now to send our blessings to her? So the idea, see these four rocks and the camera zooms out, you just gotta drizzle some water over all four of them. And that creates another power! Another brushstroke technique, or at least an improvement of one. So, with Nuragami here, we have now got a new water spout technique. We have Deluge, which that means we can make water whenever we want. So we can make an inferno and then put it out with the Deluge. Haha! Yeah, so. I believe the mark of Deluge is just 3 lines. I'll have to check on that. We don't need to use it right now, but we do need Deluge for a stray bead later. We also get a tech as well. Adding up to the trophy again. I thought it was. We'll look at it right now, actually. We check out the Water Spout Tech 2 that we just got. Oh, okay, it's 2 straight lines down. Alright. Ugh, I can use anywhere from 3 to 9. Sheesh. So, 2 down, like that. Whoa, it uses Holy Ink and makes a huge deluge. Oh, jeez. Well, alright then. I think we're done here in Seon. So now, we're gonna head to Shinshu! We've got a couple big things we need to do here in Shinshu. The first thing we might want to consider is any devil gates or any of these cursed patches of land. Yeah, go ahead and take care of those. We didn't do them in the first season because it would have really broken the flow. But yeah, if you see any devil gates or anything like that, or anything like this, go ahead and take care of him, because not only will it give you extra praise, it'll give you extra animals to feed that also give you extra praise. So, yeah, you just want to do this for extra praise, really. Yeah. So, that's not really the whole reason why we're here, though. We've got a stray bead to get, and really, that's about it. But the thing about this stray beat is that it can only be done after we rescue Lika from Waoku Shrine. So this really can only be done at the very end of the game. We head to this corner of the map, and we see a guy here. The Nameless Man. I guess because now the world is in darkness, he's able to make pottery? I guess? Well, either way, he tosses us the Azure Neck, his first vase. What are we supposed to do with it? Well, there are 5 roadside guardians hidden all throughout Shinshu, and we need to deliver these vases to each one of them. So for example, there's one roadside guardian right here. Get close enough, give him the vase, they get all clean and all non-mossified. They give you a tiny, paltry bit of praise. But if you look at the title, there's 5 vases, which means we got 4 more to go. But if you give him the vase, then run back and immediately talk to him, he's not gonna do anything. So the idea is, make it turn night, that way he goes to bed, and then you make it morning again, that way a new day dawns. And then he'll have a new vase for you. So with the indigo neck, I gotta take it to another roadside guardian. So, let's find another roadside guardian. Down here on the ramp that leads to the moon gate, head off to the side, and there's another one there. You'll also notice that my praise amount has changed a little bit because I accidentally ran through some devil gates. Again, good idea to do whenever. Best idea to do it now because you're powerful, it won't take that much time, and you'll get plenty of praise for edging out the rest of your stats. But yeah. Go ahead and make it night again, make it date again, and then we will come back for a third vase. We even go off the page if we need to. It's alright. Bring it on, Nameless Man. Alright, the Rust Neck. Worth mentioning that you can take these vases and you can run into enemies too, and you won't drop it or anything. And I'm pretty sure that if you do drop it and lose it, it'll just go right back to the Nameless Man. Anyway, it's time to find the third roadside guardian. This one's pretty easy. Going on from that first roadside guardian we got. Just head up this path, and he's just right there. Not too difficult. You should also notice that every time that we deliver a vase, we get that much more praise. So alright. Let's make it night again, make it day again, and we'll go back for our fourth vase. This is the Auburn Neck. And, yep, you guessed it, we gotta take this to yet another roadside guardian. These are getting harder and harder to find now, though. So you go by the catcall tower, or the catcall statue, and inside that bombable wall is another roadside guardian, and 20 more praise. Simple enough, I'm sure. So, yeah. Accidentally, I got hit by this enemy, which turned out to be one of the enemies we needed on our wanted list. This was a mistake, and I did not intend to do that, because we're going to be doing the wanted list in a later episode. But hey, it's going to take care of him now and get a refresher and remind ourselves that, yes, this is one more thing that we need to do. Oh, but by the way, if you kill the enemy you're supposed to kill, all the rest of the enemies die, so there's that. And it gets us a little bit of extra money, too, I suppose. But again, as a refresher, every time we accidentally kill one of these guys, we need to cross out his name on the list. I swear that's sometimes easier said than done. But that's gonna be in, like, episode 51 or something. Far later on. Right now, we need to focus on the matter at hand, which is our last vase here. It's him, it's that guy we've only seen in the past few days. Whatever, though. He's got one final vase for us, which he says it's his best. So let's see this amazing vase! Well, I guess simplicity is usually best, but I'm not one to judge pottery. I'm not really a potter. You can search around the entire map and you never find it. Because you'll never think to look just past the moon gate. Where the moon cave used to be, go just right past it, like, don't go through the path, but just go over, go past the water. And where it should be is where the last roadside guardian is. I don't know how the fuck you're supposed to know that, but here it is. And they're so proud that you found it because it gives you 50 more praise. It's amazing. Well, that's the last vase, so I guess we'll just head back to the Nameless Man and see what our prize is. I bet you can guess what it is already, though. So, best ever vase? Yeah. I don't know why you didn't give us that stray bead to begin with, but yeah. That was stray bead number 10. Bit of a time consumer, but not exactly a difficult bead. Now we can leave him, and that's about all we need to do here at Shinshu Field. Our next stop is going to be at North Ryoshima. First step here is to head out into the ocean. Because you need to head to one of those islands that are far off in the distance. We need to head to each of the islands. But for now, I think we'll start with this one that has two trees on it. Again, we need to visit every single one of these islands at some point because each of them has something that we need on them. But we'll start with this one here. Let's see, two rocks here. We can cut that rock. The second rock, this that we try to slash it. I said slash, it cannot be cut. Before we head down that hole, I guess we'll get this clover first. And we've gotten so much praise in this episode, what's a little more gonna do? Get us more power, that's what. So, with that, we'll head down into this hole. And we've reached a divine spring. What divine springs do is they're just places that can give us a whole shit ton of praise, and usually there's something special hidden within them. So bloom those trees, get ourselves a nice little bit of praise. And we'll get here and get this clover. Because there's actually three clovers in this hole. One over here, one over here. And last one over here. Gives us three praise, which isn't much, considering how much we've gotten in this entire episode. But here's the big thing here. Offerings! Give out up to 20,000 yen, 5, 10, or 20,000. So we're gonna hit 20,000, of course. That seems to be a really good thing, so we'll go ahead and jump and get. We'll go ahead and make another contribution. The best time to do these is, again, right at the end of the game. Because here, well, also after you've gotten Brown Fury. Because now you've spent your money on the biggest technique, you can now spend practically chump pocket change on these Divine Springs. Because what they get you are upgraded abilities! This is another upgraded tech. This one is for Power Slash. Essentially, the bigger the slash, the bigger the attack. The bigger our brush stroke, the more ink we use, the more powerful the stroke. The slash. You get it, don't you? Anyway. I don't even remember Tachigami. Sheesh. So learning that gives us a new chest. So now, like, is our selection probably harder things. But yeah, we get a new chest that has a new tech that details all of this. That, again, goes towards the trophy. But alright. With all that said, we've got just one more thing left to do this episode before we say our farewells until the next episode. We're gonna head back to shore now. Well, we're gonna cut this first to demonstrate our new Power Slash technique. To get a new clover. That's That's sunlight. There. That gives us 40 praise. That's impressive. I think, I guess. So yeah, we'll head back to shore. Head inside this little shack. Not the big restaurant, but the small shack that's beside it. If you remember the story of Taro Urashima, I believe I detailed that a little bit in Season 2. First time we've seen it. Well, now we're gonna get the conclusion to this quest line. We give him the treasure box that we got from the Water Dragon, his grave. I think that was also in Season 2 or 3. It was still a while ago. We give him this treasure box, and his story comes full circle, because if you remember how the story actually goes, when he opens this treasure box from the bottom of the ocean, he turns into an old man! This is apparently a good ending. I would have figured an old woman would care for a younger man, but, you know, whatever. I'm not gonna argue with true love. You know, it's married forever, it's timeless, you know, they give us praise, but whatever. Don't give a shit about the praise, don't give a shit about their love, all I care about is Stray Beat 66. And that's all we're gonna do today. Okay, let's do one more thing. Let's alleviate all of our praise, because we got so fucking much of it. Get our health up, and get our ink up, and well, that's really all we can do. Yeah. Alright, that's it for now, and we'll see you next time on Let's Play Okami HD!